depending on how they wear it and how much they have. Some folks are a lot taller than the pastor, so I have to stretch a little bit. Sometimes the ash trickles down the person's nose, down their face, maybe on their clothes. I worry they're going to blame me and do it right. One time only, I had a little boy skipped away after I put the ash on his forehead. He skipped away, which probably was the coolest thing that ever happened, you know? But it never, ever, ever happened again after that, because the whole thing's really awkward. It's awkward because death is awkward. And the people come in this long line, one by one by one by one. They come and they come and they come and they come. And compared to Sunday, it is a meager line. But it feels like that line goes on forever and ever. Remember that you're dust, and to dust you shall return. Repent and believe the good news. Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return. Repent and believe the good news. They come, old ones who know, they're talking not decades, but years. And young ones, who can almost make my voice crack just to say it, just to think of it. Remember that you're dust, and to dust you will return. It's awkward telling a whole line of people you love and a few that you've never seen before that they're going to die. That's awkward. Sometimes the emotional impact just about gets them. And the only thing keeping the whole thing together is the fact that nobody can deny it. You're going to die, and 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 you're going to die. Lord, they said, he whom you love is ill. Very human, very touching, very real story. And for most of the story, we don't think about this, but for most of the story, Lazarus is dead. Maybe that's what makes it so really dead. All that time is really, really, really dead. Lord, if you've been here, Lord, if you've been here, my brother would not have died. Which is another way of saying, Jesus, you're taking too long. You are taking too long, which seems like as real and acceptable and understandable a thing to say as anything they could have said. Lord, if you'd only been here, but you took too long. Maybe the only honest thing Mary and Martha could have possibly said, Jesus, you took too long. Though Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus, the story says, after having heard that Lazarus was ill, he stayed 2 days longer in the place where he was. 2 days, 48 hours. 48, 60-minute long hours. Jesus, you took too long. Too long. Too long. Tell me you haven't said that before. Tell me. Just tell me. I've prayed a lot of prayers that have taken Jesus a lot longer than 48 hours to answer the way I thought it ought to be answered. I have summoned Jesus for a lot of people who didn't get the kind of help that I thought they ought to get, and I wanted them to get. Jesus, you took too long. You're taking too long. And the fact of the matter is, Jesus rose from the dead, and people still die. Lazarus died, and then he died again after Jesus raised him, and this time he didn't come back at all. And the early church had a hard time, they did, with the question of why, if Jesus overcame death, why are people still dying? Why did he have to ascend into heaven? Because had he not ascended into heaven, he would have remained here on earth, and then nobody would have died. That's the way they figured. Lord, if you'd been here, my brother would not have died. Jesus, you're taking too long. Way too long. Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have also kept this man from dying? Well, couldn't he? Yeah. Story's so real, maybe more real than if Jesus had waved a finger or prayed a prayer and suddenly Lazarus would have just escaped. escape the grave altogether. Whoever saw anything like that happen anyway? So Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you'd been here, my brother wouldn't have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him. And Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. And Martha said to him, I know that he'll rise again in the resurrection on the last day. And Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet will they live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Do you believe this? And she said, yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world. Yes, I do believe, she says. And so here's the struggle, at least the best I can figure out what the struggle is. Jesus is the resurrection and the life, but he is taking his sweet time at it. And maybe that's the way we figure it out. Maybe that's the way we get it all settled out, not through some kind of magic that takes away death or pain or grief or awkward or ashes or remember that you're dust and to dust you shall return. Maybe the only way that Jesus can be the resurrection and the life is if death is still death, is still death. I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Do you? Do you? Do I? Do we? How on earth do we ever get to believe it? I don't really know. I'll never be able to explain it. How we ever really believe this? How on earth we dare to stand up at the beginning of every funeral service and say those words? Is beyond me when at the very same moment we are likely to be saying way down in our gut, Jesus, you took too long. Took too long. And when Mary runs out to Jesus with the very same words as her sister, Lord, if you'd only been here, my brother would not have died. Jesus, the resurrection and the life, can only look at her and ask, where did you lay him? Where'd you put him? Where have you laid him? Such tender words. Where have you laid him? Show me. Show me where you laid him. Where have you laid him? Mary says to her friend Jesus, she says, come and see. Come and see. The very same words used to express earlier in the Gospel of John to express the invitation of people to come and see Jesus now are used to invite Jesus near to us. Lord, come and see. Come and see where we wait. Come and see our tombs. Come and see us in our grief. Come and see us in our pain. Come and see us in our tears. Come and see us in our ashes and our dust. Come and see how awkward this is. Don't be far from us. Don't leave us alone. Please don't leave us. Please don't leave us here. Come and see. Come and see. And Jesus begins to weep. The resurrection and the life begins to weep. The resurrection and the life, we won't even perform a resurrection without a death. The one who will not take death out of the story stands at his friend's grave and he weeps. He stands at our graves and he weeps. Look how he loved him. Look, see? And I don't know if that's enough for those of us who struggle with that old enemy death. I don't know. His love and his tears mingle together with our love and our tears. Jesus, you are taking way too long with this. Way too long to put away this terrible thing done with it forever. You're taking too long. And for most of us, dare I say, our yes, Lord, I believe, comes only through struggles and questions and doubts and anger and tears and anguish and awkward and honest words like, Jesus, you are taking too long. But this Jesus, he's on his way to his own death. Yeah. The resurrection and the life is on his way to death. He's not going to skip it. He's not going to go around it. The one whose love and tears are flowing at the grave of his friend will not leave us alone in our grieving and our pain and our fear. So as you come to the table today, I invite you to bring your honesty with you. I invite you to bring the struggle with you and the words with you. Bring your Jesus, you're taking too long, and your yes, Lord, I believe. Bring it all. Receive in your open hands his body broken for you, broken with you. And receive into yourself his blood shed for you, shed with you. And receive however you can his words, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, they will still live, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to hear our
answers to prayers. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. For yours is the power of life that even death cannot hold back. You created the world and breathed your spirit into our bodies of earth, and you formed for yourself a people with whom to celebrate life. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, the one who is both life and resurrection. Sharing our grief in the face of death, he pried open the grip of the grave and called us forth into the fullness of life and peace. Arousing the fury of hell, he was crucified and cast lifeless into the depths. But you raised him to new life. Now, wherever people lay lost in valleys of death, he again comes, speaking the word of life and calling his spirit to breathe new life into us, so that hope is reborn and you are glorified. On the night in which he gave himself for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples and said, take and eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this as often as you eat it in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to the disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts of Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ will
come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the whole